Planet Dolan.
From sending robot Squid to the final frontier, to the world's longest elevator ride, we look at 9 amazing space projects that we're making right now. Hello there, my name is Shima and I'll be your feline narrator today, reading out amazing and unbelievable facts while you get nice and cozy. Number 9. Sometimes life imitates art. And in this case, that art involves throwing spaceships into the goddamn sun. Okay, so if you ever saw sunshine, you know that getting anything remotely close to the sun is very difficult, mainly because nothing on Earth can take the heat, literally. So this project to launch a probe to get within 4 million miles of the star is almost like something out of science fiction. Solar Probe Plus will help us understand the dynamic between magnetic fields and solar winds, which, admittedly, isn't as exciting as throwing a nuke into the sun, but this research will probably let us do that. If we ever have to, I mean. It's not like NASA has a vendetta against the sun or anything. That solar storm in 1859 burning out all the telegraph lines is just a thing of the past. Assuming it doesn't happen again, of course. And cause all the electronics on Earth to fry.
Number 8.
Man, Venus must be so jealous about all the attention we pay to Mars. I mean, Venus is way hotter. Well, don't worry, Venus. Russia has had a hard-on for you that hasn't gone away in over 50 years. They've been sending probes to check out Venus for a long time, and what they've discovered is that she's a solid 10. So that's why they're sending a new probe in about 10 years. Venera D will be the flagship for a whole new line of Venusian-inclined probes. But, I don't know, this seems like the interplanetary version of sending a friend request to that hot girl from high school that you never had a chance with. Or perhaps stalking. Venus stalking Russians. That sounds like a weird B-movie you just can't help but go and see.
Number 7.
In the near future, one of Jupiter's moons will be totally populated by robotic squid. No, seriously, they're actually trying to do this. NASA recently announced a concept they're working on to explore the subsurface oceans of Europa. Now, while pictures of our neighboring worlds are great and all, this one is exciting for a very specific reason. Alien life. Many believe that Europa's oceans hold the best chance for finding life outside of Earth but inside our solar system. But even if there's nothing there, at least we've successfully populated another world with robots. How cool is that?
Number 6.
Our first venture outside of our solar system may be here with the development of these crazy microsatellites. This deep space exploration group at University of California wants to use microwafer satellites, propelled by phased laser arrays to go where no one has gone before. These microsatellites would provide us with huge amounts of information about the challenges of leaving our solar system. They would also work as our eyes and ears on the fringes, making the tracking of things like asteroids easier. Then interstellar travel is right around the corner, because you don't go there until you probe there.
Number 5.
While some projects like Mars One and SpaceX have been touting that they'll get to Mars first, they weren't counting on China entering the race. China recently announced that they were bypassing their plans to go to the moon by saying, "Fuck it, we'll go to Mars instead, that'll show them." While China's designs on Mars are quite small in comparison to Elon Musk wanting to build a colony on Mars, it seems like they might just beat everyone there, or at least kickstart NASA into doing, I don't know, something?
Number 4.
From selling records in the back of someone's shop to conquering space, this is one virgin with a lot of experience. Richard Branson's dream of creating a fleet of spaceships had a minor setback when their ship, Enterprise, kinda crashed. But recently, they showed off their brand new craft and announced they were going back into testing. Branson's ships would allow people to fly to the very edges of Earth's atmosphere, opening the door for future space tourism. Which, hell, in our lifetime may be as close as we get to visiting the stars. Dang it, science fiction, you promised me we'd be living on the moon by now! And where the hell is my flying car? Or at least give me a hoverboard? Please?
Number 3.
Just getting out of Earth's atmosphere hasn't been a problem for a while. It's more the whole, how do we travel fast in space issue. While warp drive or riding through wormholes isn't available yet, one research group might have a solid answer. The Vasmir engine, which uses superheated plasma, could shorten the travel time between Earth and Mars to just 5 months. With the right power, the developer believes it could be done in 39 days each way. In comparison to what we have now, that's like taking a ship from London to New York compared with taking a 747.
Number 2.
And then this one comes along and it's like flying on the Concorde compared to that jumbo jet. New theoretical developments around a theory from 1994, called the Alcubierre drive, have opened up the possibility of warp drive. But at the moment, these breakthroughs have only given the theory a slim chance of being workable. So, while not quite the warp core Scotty would be fixing up, NASA has been taking the first steps at testing what could take us beyond our solar system. But don't plan on getting to be a red shirt anytime soon. Theorists believe that any working craft wouldn't be around until the year 2100.
Number 1.
But don't worry too much about that, because here's one that will be around in your lifetime. Probably. Multiple organizations around the world are currently working on technology that would create an elevator in space! Japanese company Obayashi believe that using carbon nanotechnology and maglev similar to bullet trains will get them into space by 2050. Essentially, it would mean that we would be able to ferry objects and people to a space station without the whole ridiculously expensive rocket launch thing. But one estimate said that it would take about a week to get you up there. Oh, you can go into space, but you have to endure 7 days of shitty elevator music. Thanks, future. Now I'll never get the girl from Ipanema out of my head.
Thanks for listening. Bye.
Dang it!
That's right. Not only did they manage to build something like a 20th century city out of nothing but wet dirt, they built them 500 years before anything like it existed. We should all be building houses out of mud, guys!